Hello everybody, and welcome to another Genshin Impact reaction. This is the Ignition teaser, a name forged in flames, which I think is the first story tease of the Natlan region. Now this video is actually older than the previous reaction episode I did on Lil Buddies, which was probably for the best since that was a non-story related one, probably save the chunkier stuff for a little bit later, which is what I'm doing now. This is the meat and bone here, so I'm very eager to see what we're gonna be shown in this. This was released specifically on the 11th of July, 2024, so a little over a month ago now. And it only has 5.6 million views. I am extremely stoked for this. Stoked? Fire? Pyro? Natlan? Coincidence? So for people that are new to these videos, of course, there are timestamps at the top of the description if you want to just go through the uninterrupted reaction to the video, to the trailer, or teaser, I guess it says, or if you would like to go to the discussion portion, or if you'd like to skip certain portions, all of that is there for you to click and use. But one last thing I would say is, since I've been reacting to these Natlan teasers, I would suggest that you listen to at least each of the reactions in order that I had uploaded them, because that's the order that I had recorded them in, so you can see the evolution of my opinion on Natlan as we go through them. And the reason why I took a break quick from character demos and from A Winter Night's Lazo, which I know people wanted me to get to, which we will, was because I want to be part of this Natlan hype train. This is the first time that I can be part of this, you know, part of a new region in Genshin Impact, and witness it with other people. So, without further ado, let's begin. I turned the subtitles off because I assume it's going to be in English. Okay. 3, 2, 1, go. I got an ugly ass smile on my face. Wait, is this animated? What the
attention,
hell?
Please. Kachina will now release the ball to promote the upcoming tournament.
Huh? Gotta get a photo to remember it.
That's too close.
Great.
Oh, she's so fucking adorable. I hate it.
Too far.
What? What? Who the heck are you?
Get out of here! Leave me alone!
Spicy.
Oh no. Cat mommy.
Is it that time of year again?
Oh, it's that! Slow down! That's the person from the...
I need a break.
I wonder if she's watching.
Who's watching? The Archon? Oh, this place! Oh my god, it's all coming together now. We saw this in a previous teaser. Hello?
Embrace your competitive spirit and give your all. The battle is for winners only. The champion will take all.
Are you brave enough to compete?
Hmm.
to burn again. Even the tiniest of sparks will not go unnoticed.
Did you catch everything?
Who? What? Oh, good, it's the Dragon Balls.
What our eyes see ought to be our fate. But now, close your eyes and feel. For with our blood, we will forge our true fate.
Oh, the music, man. The music in this place. I mean, I doubt we're going to hear that music because I've learned in the past that apparently they have unique music for trailers oftentimes. But if that's the kind of thing I can expect to hear, oh, chef's kiss. I am so ready for this. Okay, whoa. I was not expecting to see a million freaking characters. So it looks like the whole tournament thing is definitely happening. Which is this place. So we saw this place in a previous teaser, and I thought it was a settlement. Like, where, you know, people were living and stuff like that, just in this little circular area. But no, it's apparently a tournament arena, I guess. So now I've got the context for that. I also was not expecting, like, an animated trailer. Or semi-animated, whatever, however you want to refer to this. That was pretty cool to see. Okay, let's look at the description, since I was told to do that plenty of times, and I will make sure to continue to do that. So the description reads, O God of fire, infernos, and war, your fate forged amidst strife, your path paved in glory and names renowned, your radiance resembles the setting sun's might. Under the assembled stars' flames we gather, to bear witness to the triumphs and defeats of this tournament. So, before I look at these voice actors here, which might actually help me figure out who the frick anybody is in this trailer, since there's a ton of characters, we have a tournament, okay? Now, I kind of jokingly mentioned this in a previous Natlan teaser that we looked at. I was like, oh, everything's got to have its tournament arc. If you have any anime or game that looks or resembles anime, it is law to have a tournament arc. It just seems to be, if there's a beach episode and then there's the tournament episode. It always happens, right? Now, I'll be completely honest with you guys, you know, especially those of you that know me more than if this is your first time listening to my dumbass talk on the internet. I have a hit-or-miss relationship with tournament arcs in anime. Sometimes I absolutely love them. Sometimes I think they are a drag and I wish they were done with. So I'll be curious to see how Genshin Impact does it. I mean, I guess the difference here is that I actually get to play the game as opposed to watch it play out. So perhaps it'll be a little bit more fun and interactive in that way. Because no doubt we are going to be a central focus in the tournament, right? There's no freaking way it's not going to be part of the main story. Now, what I would like to know, because, of course, now this is more of a story focus, so I have more of relevance to talk about this now, but this is something I have discussed in the previous Natlan videos as well, and I'm going to discuss it again, right? So you can skip this part if you want, otherwise, just let it play out. But that is the idea that Natlan, that there's supposed to be some conflict happening. Now, I may have mistaken it as being the clans infighting with each other, but that doesn't seem to be the case, outside of perhaps the clans do fight each other, but more like tiny little sparring skirmishes, rather than an actual war, which I guess would that count as a civil war, even if they're all three completely different tribes? I don't know how that works. I don't know the logistics there, but there definitely is some sort of conflict that is supposedly occurring, or will be occurring, based on dialogue in the actual game from Nouvellet and the Knave. So I am curious to see where that's going to go with the story. A lot of people that have commented on this to me, or messaged me about it, has basically suggested the idea that perhaps the country is not yet in conflict, and it is a coming conflict that will come out in the later part of the Archon story. Like Natlan, you know how they always release the first section of the main story Archon for a new region, and then we get the rest comes out later on? You know, that might be what they're doing. So maybe the first part of Natlan's Archon story is going to be the tournament arc, and then after that we're going to start getting serious, you know, like really serious. Similar to how Fontaine was like that, right? Fontaine started off with this beautiful new nation we go to, just like how everyone likes telling me that this is apparently a beautiful nation that only exists for tourism, perhaps that is exactly going to work, or excuse me, that's going to work exactly the way that Fontaine did. We went to Fontaine, it was a gorgeous new country, we're like, oh my god, they have aqua buses and oh, the technology, holy crap, look at their city, it's so freaking huge, and they have this massive theater, oh my god, oh, the Archon, you know, that's how it was when we first went there. And then suddenly it got depressing. You know, and everything got, there was these stakes, the whole country was at risk, there was like, oh my god, slow down. So perhaps Natlan's going to have the same thing. And if so, I'm all for it. And I hope so, that that's the case. You know, because, yeah, I would love to see a massive conflict, or at least some sort of conflict occur in Genshin. We saw some of that in Inazuma, with the fighting that went there between the resistance and stuff. We saw some big battles that took place. But I would like to see that here in Natlan as well. Especially a nation ruled by a god of war. It would be most impressive that if you were going to go to war with any nation, you choose to go to war with the nation that has a god named after war. That would be kind of dumb sounding. Why would you make that mistake? Okay, now I guess let's start looking at what we actually can see in the trailer here. So at the beginning we have, so I guess the little whatever she is, this adorable thing here, I don't know what type of animal she's supposed to be, but her name is what did she say, Katrina, or was it Kachina?
No, we'll now release, let's attention, please. Kachina will now release.
Kachina. Okay.
Huh? Gotta get a photo to remember it.
Hey, that's too close. Huh?
Oh. I hate how adorable these characters look, man. They do this on purpose. Because then you're like, ooh, I want to pull for them. You know, I like pulling for all the characters that are adorable. So, of course, I have no choice. Although, I was actually just told before doing this, that this character on the left is actually going to be a free character. You will be given her, I guess, for progressing in the Natlan storyline, or maybe an event or something, I don't know. But you can get her for free. Free, in quotations. You know, I don't have to put down polls for her, but unless you want, of course, constellations. But that's great, so that means that I am automatically insured to acquire this adorable new character. And then on the right, we've got the fish girl, but I'm not really sure what her name is. So in the description, I almost said comments, we have, okay, there's Kachina. So are they in the order that we're shown them, maybe? Which would mean Mualani, I guess? Mualani? I'm not going to be able to pronounce any of these names, dude. I can't pronounce half the names in the game already. And now we've got a whole new culture of enunciation that I have to try and figure out. So, assuming that is the fish girl, that's who we see there. Well, stop trying to click that button.
And too far!
So, I don't know what this thing is, a ball? What did she say it is?
Let's go! Attention, please! Kachina will now release the ball to promote the upcoming tournament.
Okay, it's an advertisement ball, apparently, I guess. And we can also see in the background, though this is most likely just like concept art that they'll be using for the animation, this looks like the Hydro tribe or clan, right? Because we saw this structure in the background in one of the previous teasers when we also saw the shark girl, I think. So I'm assuming that this is where they're positioned. And also it's very blue and misty looking, you know, like you're on the coast.
Attention, please.
Get a photo. Great.
The way, oh my god, just the way she darts her eyes up at the camera for a brief moment. Great. Right there. Oh, I hate this. And her eyes wiggle. Her ears wiggle.
And go.
Okay. So then we're shown this guy, who was also in a previous teaser. These were the first three that they showed off. Let's see, is his name down here? Kinich? Whatever. Starts with a K. I'm assuming because there's a male voicing the character, so I'm assuming that this is him. Maybe they must go in order then, I'm guessing. Perhaps. Maybe not. I don't know. In which case is... interesting that they do that. It's actually very helpful if that's how that works. But let's see. So...
Son of a...
Starting to get spicy with the language in this game. Now he says... Did he say pass there? Let me turn on the subtitles actually just to see.
Pass.
Now I am a little bit curious, okay, because he seems to have this pixely thing going on. I don't know what the hell this is. Well, we've got like a pixel artwork sprite thing here. This might be related to his... I mean, if you look at his design on his character as well, which I didn't really talk about their character designs, since I was kind of saving that for like character demos and stuff. But since this is my first exposure, first proper exposure, he's got lots of little squares, like little pixel symbols all over him. So this must have something to do with his abilities or his whatever. I'll be honest in saying I don't really like what I'm seeing here. I don't like this pixel sprite. This does not look like Genshin to me, in my opinion. That's just my personal opinion. Of course, you don't have to agree with that. And I'm not being super negative over it. I just don't think this looks or feels like Genshin. There's plenty of cubes in this game, but not little pixel sprites. So if he like summons this little guy as his skill or something, that's going to be really distracting. But we'll see. Anyways, he passes to a new character. Okay. A new character is in one I haven't seen yet in a previous teaser. Now, again, I am already intrigued. I love the color palette, the pinks and light blues and the light sort of pale purples. Again, I'm seeing another character I'm going to want to collect.
What the heck is that?
She seems really angry, and I kind of like it. I love her, the design, though. Her eyes are gorgeous. She's got, like, these blue, pink pupils and just gorgeous blue eyes. Oh, man. Shoot, I don't have the wallet to facilitate buying my way through characters anymore, so I'm going to have to just try to survive. But most of these characters aren't going to be coming out right away. It's going to be, they're going to be drip-fed to us over Natlan's persistent existence, you know? So, because I'm pretty sure we're getting the Shark Girl and at least Kachina, I guess, at first, when Natlan releases. I don't think any of the other characters are popping out right away. And again, I have to just comment on the music here. Like, just...
Too far! Son of a...
Pass.
I love when they do that. Really gonna suck if that music isn't in the game, but I'm not going to expect it because, like I said before, I learned that a lot of the music I've heard is not actually in or from the game. It's from the trailers and promotional content, which sucks, but the music I'm hearing sounds great. If that's a sign of what I can expect to hear in Natlan, that's just, I mean, I love when they implement electric guitars and shit into the mix of all these other instruments and stuff like that. They do that, especially in boss fights, they do that kind of thing, and it's just, oh, I love that kind of thing so freaking much. And with what I'm hearing so far from Natlan, like, we haven't heard any, you know, like, boss or battle tracks or anything like that in the teasers, but it sound, I loved the that flute thing, that wind instrument. I have no idea what it's called. I talked about this in the previous Natlan teaser video I looked at. That thing is going to melt my brain in all the best ways possible while I'm exploring Natlan. So I look forward to hearing that instrument used. But when you consider that this is a nation ruled by the god of war, I would expect battle tracks, or especially boss tracks, to sound pretty fucking badass, right? Powerful and destructive, maybe. But we'll see. I am really always eager for new battle tracks, since I tend to use those as my intro videos in Genshin for my Genshin Let's Play. But I'm always looking forward to new weekly boss themes. Those guys tend to have the best of the best when it comes to battle tracks in the game. And, I'll save that for another video where I talk about the game's OST, but I've been pretty satisfied. I was absolutely adoring boss tracks, especially in Inazuma. I still think that Inazuma overall had the best weekly boss tracks. And then we came to Sumeru, which has more good boss tracks, including my personal favorite one in the entire game, but I think that Inazuma still won out as far as both go. And then, of course, we come to Fontaine, which was interesting because I felt a change in the way that the music sounds. So I'm not really sure what's going on there, unless it has something to do with the original like composer that was working on writing the music and stuff leaving. Maybe that had something to do with it. Like, I really liked the Devouring Narwhal track. Specifically, what I liked about that song was that they implemented, as much as I can't stand whales, I'm terrified of those things, I loved how they implemented natural whale noises with the use of instruments at the beginning of that song. Such a great artistic choice for that. And then, of course, Arlecchino's boss theme, which, it's a Harbinger theme. I don't give any other shits. If there's a Harbinger theme, I'm living and breathing it for the rest of my life, because I live to hear that Harbinger motif. Anywhere I go, I need to hear that music play. So, yeah. Anyways, point is, I'm looking forward to music in Natlan.
I'll be here. Leave me alone!
Leave me alone! Okay, some weird new birds. What did we see there? Ooh. Down a tree. Okay, then we've got this character. And I was like, oh, geez. Another Geo character. I didn't even look and see what the vision was. I'm assuming this guy's Dendro. Just an assumption. Maybe if he's not Dendro, he's probably the green one. But can we see? Oh, she's Cryo. You can see it just right there. Okay. All right. Noted. Now for this lady, who is Geo, and I'm, as I said when we were watching the trailer for the first time, I was like, oh no, it's a cat mommy. This is gonna be a really hard, hard as in not me, well, I don't know, but this is going to be a, whatever, shut the fuck up, what the hell, dude. This is going to be a really difficult, I don't know if I'm supposed to say patch, because they're not all coming out in the same update. Natlan is going to be a difficult Archon story while it's new to exist through because of all these new characters. That's what I'm trying to say. Because I cannot make enough resources with the fact that I play semi-frequently and sometimes semi-infrequently. So there's no way that I can gather up enough resources to effectively earn all of these characters. Unless I got really lucky with pulls, right? Which sucks. Because I'm seeing a lot of cool designs that I really want to have. Now here we've got some cat. I don't know, maybe she's based on, she's got spots on her tail. So I'm thinking, I used to know this, but notice how her spots have little dots on them. And the way that the spots themselves are surrounded by like a dark line. I used to know, but there is a way to tell between the difference between like leopards and cheetahs. Well, I mean, obviously a cheetah, you can clearly tell. Like a jaguar and a leopard, for example, they look pretty similar unless you look really closely. But the one way to tell easily is their spot design. They have different looking spots. And I don't remember if she's supposed to be a cheetah, though. That's my favorite fucking animal. And I don't give any shit. She's going in my collection if that's the case. But I can't tell what exactly she's supposed to be. But some large cat, obviously. So she's tired, having her old cat nap. That time of year again. So I guess we hold this tournament once a year, it sounds like. One thing I'm looking to see exactly how it works in the game is she's yawning, so she's obviously tired, and the other character is feisty. One point of criticism I've always had with Genshin is that, and you will hear me talk about this a lot when we're doing the character demos, is that characters in Genshin are pretty one-dimensional, the way that they're written. Now, you can scream at me all you want about lore, but that's outside the game. Most of it, anyways, okay? Most of this, the stuff you learn about characters, you're gonna learn through freaking books and wiki pages and shit like that. You're not gonna learn it through interacting with them. The way you interact with them in the game is usually one of two different ways. You have characters that actually have a point in the story and have more to their character than just one single defining character trait, and that's all you ever freaking hear them talk about or do. So seeing her yawn, the first thing I think of, because of the way Genshin usually writes their characters, is, uh-oh, I'm gonna have a big cat mommy who is constantly tired, and that's the only defining trait of her character. She's constantly tired. Just like how Ganyu is constantly tired because she works all the time, and that's the only freaking thing that you ever hear whenever you're playing with her. So we'll see if that's how it works. I think they've been doing better at that as new characters come out, it's the older characters that especially suffer from that issue. So with these being literally the newest of new for characters, I'll be curious. Okay, so... all right, and then we got this character here, who is... this is the character from the freaking Teyvat chapter teaser that we watched, the very first episode of the reaction series, I think. Except it looks like she's had some detail upgrades, right? She or he, actually. I don't actually know if this is a she or a he. But it's another small character. Now, I wrongfully had the idea that that was supposed to be the Pyro Archon, for whatever reason. I mean, people pointed out to me that there is no confirmation of that, and this is not the Pyro Archon in that original video, which makes sense because none of the other characters were Archons, so why would the Pyro one be an Archon? You know what I mean? So I don't know why I made that mistake. It's just an honest mistake, okay? But this character is... oh, I didn't even look at the cat character. So Almighty Dragon Lord, self-proclaimed, Kuhul Aja. I guess that's that feisty girl, maybe. And then there's Kitlali, who might be the cat mommy. And then, no, wait, actually there's... no, because this is Ian-san. That's supposed to be this character, right? Because I actually know that name. Did I miss a character in here? Either I missed a character, I did not miss a character. So these aren't in order then. Because I don't know who the hell the Almighty Dragon Lord self-proclaimed is in that case. Because there's an extra name in here that I don't know which one is what. Whatever. I love that it just bounces off of her head. And you just hear, that's so hilarious. Or he, I don't know. Okay? I haven't heard them speak.
The tournament. I wonder if she's watching.
See, and this is just another moment. Another great character design. I love the look of this. I also didn't mention that it looks like this little character here is an elf look to them, or has an elf look to them. And then, I mean, just another elf character, it looks like. Which, honestly, we don't have many of those in the game, do we? There's Klee and stuff. How many others are there? Not many, I don't think. But another great character design, at least from what, in my opinion. I love the colors, the red, maroony, purpley look, the blue eyes, of course. Another curiosity. I can't see her vision, though, so I'm not sure what she is. In fact, I don't even think you could see the vision on the previous character either. It's probably down on, like, their waist or their back or something. And she says, I wonder if she's watching. My best assumption is that they're talking about the Pyro Archon. Who else would they be talking about? Oh, also, I didn't mention. I wanted to mention, but the music here that plays. It's that wind instrument again. I don't know what that is. I don't know what it is, but it sounds awesome. I need that. I need that in my life, please. Okay, so now we're at the... of course, there's flames. I wonder why. Now, who in the hell are you? Is this supposed... who is this? She looks flashy as hell. That's not the Archon, is it? Is it? I don't know. Nobody says anything. Is she just the one who runs the tournament? You know? Like, I can look in the comment, or I can look in the description, but that ain't gonna tell me which one's which here, because I'm out of... oh my god, there's actually someone here named Katrina. So I said Kachina, and then I mistook Kachina as Katrina. There's Casca, I guess? And Mavuika? And then the Captain, who is definitely the Harbinger. And then whatever... Ororon is... fucking, I don't know, man. I don't know. But my best guess, I guess, My best guess, I guess, is if this isn't the Archon herself, then this is the person who runs the tournament. Which, interesting design. Can't say it's really my style. She's got boob zippers. She's got boob zippers. What is that? I don't know what doesn't really do it for me for the design. Maybe it's the hair. It's a bit too big for me. That's just my personal thing, not a criticism against the game or anything. It's just a personal preference. And maybe it's the glasses. I don't know. I love glasses, but not really flashy sun ones. Her eyes are interesting. They look like the sun. Oh, and hear this music, man. Oh, this music.
The tournament will soon begin. My dear friends, take your positions. Embrace your competitive spirit and give your all.
Embrace eternity.
This battle is for winners only. The champion will take all.
I cannot stop with this music, though.
Embrace your competitive spirit and give your all. This battle is for winners only. The champion will take all.
Okay, what did she say? The champion will take... Oh, will take all. Okay, I thought she said will take on, but then didn't say anything. Will take on who? But no, she says will take all. Okay, oh, she is a... What is she? Is that Cryo, I think? I'm pretty sure that's Cryo. If it's not Cryo, it's the green one, the windy one. Okay, can we see anything with this character? No. I can't see her vision anywhere. Adorable, of course. Because, fucking course, all the characters are adorable. And there's her again. So she says the winner will take all, and then we're flashing through all of these characters. So I'm assuming all of these characters are going to be part of the tournament. Oh, man. Man, Kachina is so adorable. It's just, look at that little face and those big, giant, floofy ears. Okay, here's some interesting stuff. So we've got some weird dragon bird thing. And who in the world is that on the right? I don't know. You really don't get a chance to look at them. But this is the captain, I guess, who is a harbinger, right? I don't really know much about him other than what's been briefly mentioned, if I remember correctly, in the game from point to point. So I don't know anything really about this guy. I don't know what his frickin' power level is. I think someone actually posted a comment on my original video that explained... Hold on just a moment. Let me pause the recording here. Okay, yeah, I went to look at a list that someone had commented on the rankings of the Harbingers, and the captain is ranking number 1, which implies that he's kick-ass, basically. So, okay, I guess I'm going to have to be ready for that. But no idea who the hell this other person is. That must be, I'm assuming, one of the other characters that shows up in the description that I didn't recognize. Well, actually, I don't recognize any of them except 2. So I don't know who's who here.
Are you brave enough to compete?
All right. Very interested to see what this guy's all about.
Are you brave enough to compete?
Okay, and then we get some weird stuff here. Great music, though. Like, what is that? Is it a spirit ball of fire? And look, it looks like the cheese again. It looks like, remember with that thing that was swimming through the melted cheddar cheese with the oil on top? That's what this looks like. It's got the bright orange with the, like, the whitey blue stuff.
Time to burn again.
I guess they're one in the same.
Even the tiniest of...
Dude, she's got... Hold on a minute. Hold on a minute. Where does this character appear for the first time? She's got more than a boob zipper.
The tournament.
She got freaking boob zippers for each individual boob, and then she's got a massive zipper in the middle for both of her boobs. She got three boob zippers. Actually, this seems like a full body zipper. What in the world is she wearing? Can't say I'm really too big a fan of her outfit, personally. But I find it funny that she's got three zippers for her tits.
Did you catch everything?
Who? Did who catch anything? Me? Oh my god, it's the Archon! That'll be the Pyro Archon right there. We'll just be playing as five balls. Six balls. What are those symbols in the balls? Fuck if I can tell. Maybe it's the six symbols we saw in the first Natlan teaser. The three Saurian symbols and then the three presumably tribe symbols. Clan symbols? I don't know why I've gone from clan down to tribe.
But now, close your eyes and feel.
Hear, think, feel. I just, whatever. And that's it. Damn. Okay. So, the first bit of Natlan is going to be tournament arc. Oh, joy. We'll see. Hopefully it's not the 50% of the time where I don't like the art, I almost said artifact grinding. I don't know why I went to artifact grinding, which is about 100% of the time I don't like artifact grinding. But hopefully it's not the 50% of the time that I don't like the tournament arc. We'll just have to see. Otherwise, this was a fun trailer because I wasn't expecting the animated style to it. We got to see a bunch of new characters that have really cool designs. And we get a little bit of a tease here, what's going on with the new Harbinger. And that's pretty much it. Oh man, it is getting me excited, I have to say. Even though this wasn't like some ridiculously crucial, I guess it was pretty crucial, but I mean it wasn't like a cinematic. Basically, and yet it's still getting me all excited and giddy and stuff. I mean, it was happening during when I was reacting to the trailer. I don't remember where it was, but I just started like laughing and giggling and clapping. That was me getting excited for something that I don't even know why I was getting excited. I was just getting excited. It was filling my veins with ecstasy, I guess, just being able to see new Genshin stuff and be part of the new Genshin stuff. When I say be part of it, by the way, because I mentioned this earlier, that's obviously I've played the game each time a new nation comes out, but I mean be there to watch the trailers before the nation comes out. You know, be here with everyone else to see these things before, you know, Natlan comes out and be able to react to these and share the excitement or whatever might be the case. Now, I will say that as excited as I am for this, I still have these reservations or something in my brain. Like, I'm not feeling super, super overwhelmingly excited as I was for, say, Fontaine, Sumeru, Inazuma. So we'll just have to see if something clicks it somewhere. But the music, I'm certainly going there for the music, at least. The music and the land and some of these new characters. And I don't think there's anything else in here unless it's something that I specifically missed. Now, I wonder... Actually, wait a minute. I didn't even look. Does she have a... Because if she doesn't have a vision, then that would make her the Archon, wouldn't it? Unless she is a non-playable character and is just a story character, that could also be the case. But she might wear the vision on her frickin' ass. who knows, you know, on her back or something. But we got to see her walking, didn't we? Does she have vision anywhere? Not here. She just seems too flashy to be a normal character. I don't see a vision, just three boob zippers. Huh. I guess that's something that I'm sure people will tell me in the comments. Be like, you dumb fucking shit, that's not the Archon, that's supposed to be blah 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 blah. You should have known this because she was mentioned in a single line of dialogue in some random fucking NPC's house back in Liyue or something, is what someone's going to say. But okay. I don't see anything else in here to delve into. I think we delved into pretty much everything that I noticed. As far as the characters I want to see in the game, and I kind of want to playtest, that would be her. She's, I think, highest on the list, because I think she's the cutest. Not counting Kachina, because I know she's coming, but I mean characters that aren't coming yet. Would be this character, and then second to... Or this character being second to that, this cat lady. And then I also want to... I'm curious to see about her, too, because I like her hairstyle that she's got going. And then also the little shit that was running around. Where is she? There she is. Or he. I don't know. I don't know. It sounds like a she, though. Because that just looks like a fun... Looks like a little brute. Like, this is going to be a Claymore user type thing. I mean, look, she's got a bandage or something over her nose. Unless that's specifically for training. I doubt it. But, I mean, she's wearing knuckles. Not brass knuckles. But she's got rings on every knuckle. Like, she could punch your... gut and just knock you out. She was wearing a fucking skull on her head. I would say she's gonna kick some ass if she's anything. I love that. Whatever. Okay. So, yeah, that was finally some story stuff. And I don't think we're done with Natlan just yet. Natlan reactions. I think there's a couple more, though I don't know if any of them are as big as the Ignition teaser or anything. I guess that remains to be seen. But we'll see. Moving forward, there's also this version over here. This is like a version update trailer, which I'm guessing shows gameplay and stuff, which I haven't actually reacted to any version updates yet. I might toss that one in there anyways, just because it's the new stuff, and then go back and keep working on the old stuff as we, you know, move through it. But, of course, as I always say, suggest other reactions that you want me to look at or consider in the comment section. I want to get around to everything at some point, but I'm most likely going to be bouncing all over the place like I am right now. And so it's very possible I will miss something. And if I do, then, well, rip. You know? That's what you guys are there to let me know I missed something. Then I could be like, oh, shit. Then I add it to the list or go back and cross it off the list. If I skipped over it on accident. Anywho, guys, Natlan's coming. It's only a couple weeks away. And I'm looking forward to seeing what more it has to offer. Until next time, though, I'll see you guys around. Goodbye.